Hi, and welcome to another Bitwig episode. My name is Mattias. Okay, so what's the difference between the Dynamics processor and the compressor of the Bitwig Studio? Let's find out! In the previous episode, we were discussing how to create a multiband compressor within Bitwig Studio. This time, we're going to take a look at the differences between the Dynamics and the compressor. So here I have recorded a little bass line, a little bass line, and I deliberately played it with a very high dynamic range, so I'm playing some quiet parts and a little bit more powerful parts. And the bass part sounds like this. So you can hear that we have some quieter sections and some more powerful transients. And it's always a good practice to add a spectrum analyzer to your audio tracks when you're recording audio, because as we can see here, we have some hiss going on in the upper range of the register. So what we do is we just add an equalizer to get rid of the absolute lows and these higher hiss frequencies. So now we have a much cleaner signal to work with. Okay, so let's first take a look at the Dynamics processor. And I will reset all the settings here, so we have just a clean line. And there has been some misconception about this Dynamics device, that somebody thought that it's a multiband compressor, but it's actually, if you can see, if we hover over this low threshold, it will say threshold for the low stage, used for the quieter parts of the signal, and this high threshold, threshold for the high stage, used for the louder parts of the signal. So this is actually our audio level, and we have the quieter section down here and the more loud parts up here. So if we look at this graph while playing back the track, we see this little white dot jumping around on this orange line. And that's where the audio level or the audio peak is at that specific moment in time. So what we can do with this Dynamics processor, we can actually control how the quieter parts are going to behave. So let's see if we adjust this curve, dragging down the ratio, so we have so we drag down the curve, it will actually make the quieter sections even more quiet. And we can also drag this second slider for the higher parts or the louder parts of the sound, and we can do upwards compression, and this is called expansion. So now we have tipped. We have tipped the curve so that the quieter sections get more quiet and the more loud parts get even louder. So we have a very high dynamic range. And we can compare that to the unprocessed signal. Yeah, in this case, it's not very good practice to add expansion, but it's a great example, I think, to see what this Dynamics device actually do to your, what it can do with your audio file. So now we've done some expansion. Then if we reset the controls, just double click all these knobs, and we reset them, then we can increase the ratio for the upper range. And now we are doing compression. So the louder parts of the signal will be pushed down. Then we can also push up the quieter sections. like this and compressing the quieter section. So now we're evening out the signal. So the quieter gets more loud and the loud part get compressed. So that we even out this signal. Yeah, so that's compressing with the Dynamics processor. And we can see that it sounds very transparent. We don't have any coloration or no apparent coloration of the sound because it sounds like the original take, except that it's heavily compressed. Even if we set these attack and release times to quite drastic and fast times, yeah, here we start to have some coloration because the attack and release are so high set. But it's still quite transparent, not too much. And then some other features of the Dynamics processor or the Dynamics device is that we have sidechain. So we can actually sidechain this too. If we record some kicks in here. So we can attach that kick drum from this producer essentials kit. We can attach that to this device input. If we go to group, select our producer kit and drum chain and the kick. Now when we have attached the kick to this device as a sidechain input, you can see this little icon that it represents that we feed a signal into this Dynamics compressor. Now you can see as soon as we have signal coming in from the kick, it will compress and drag down the volume of the bass. Down here we can increase the volume for the sidechain input. So if we have a very low kick or a very low hi-hat that feeds this sidechain, we can increase the volume if we want. So we get more effect on this compression. Yeah, so that's the sidechain compression part and the Dynamics plugin. So that's a quite a transparent compressor with many features. And now let's go and look at the compressor device. Let's reset all these parameters by double clicking again. Okay, so let's see if we increase the ratio and set the threshold so that it evens out our signal. And since this is a bass, we can set the attack quite high because we don't want so much transients popping out, because we want to even out this bass line. So the compressor is affecting the whole frequency range. It's not separate bands, this is a full frequency, full spectrum frequency compressor. And the Dynamics is also full frequency. So the compressor and the Dynamics compressors are full frequency compressors. they are not affecting only the bass or only the highs. If you want to do that, you have to use this multiband effect setup to split the bands and then apply compressors to the different bands. So what's cool with this compressor is that it's emulating the 1176 UREI with a FET transistor. So that you get the coloration to the sound if you start to increase the input gain. And if we decrease the attack and releases. Okay, so what's good with this compressor is that it's emulating 1176, kind of. So that if we decrease the attacks and releases, we can get some really gnarly and gritty sounds out of this compressor. So let's experiment a little bit with that. There we have the clean signal, and then with a little bit of saturation and fuzz. So you can use this compressor very effectively to introduce a little bit of saturation to your sounds. Yeah, so that's the main differences between the compressor and the Dynamics plugin. So with the Dynamics plugin, you can do expansion and you can do compression, but with the compressor, it's only compression, but with some more saturation. Okay, so what do you think about the compressors of the Bitwig Studio? Do you like them? I think they are quite decent for, I mean, a native compressor. They should be transparent and not add too much coloration, and I think they do a decent job at that. Personally, I'd like to introduce some grit to my sounds, so I tend to use third-party compressors most of the time. And this free compressor called Molot is very good. I'll include a link in the description so you can check it out. And this is really good for adding some grit into your sounds. Okay, so if you don't have Bitwig, don't fear, because there's a link in the description, an affiliate link, and there should also be a discount code. If you want to support these videos, you can buy any of my sound packs. There's links in the description. I have a special producer essentials pack for Bitwig Studio with a lot of presets and a great producer essentials drum kit. And I also have another sound pack in development for Bitwig Studio that will be released quite soon. Okay, so now you can continue and watch my next video. Thanks for watching today. Please subscribe, hit the thumbs up, and write some nice comment in the feedback. It's always appreciated. Thanks a lot for watching today, and see you in the next video. Bye.